What is the most important thing you want the American people to understand at this important juncture of history?
First, convey to them that the people of Iraq are not the enemy of the American people. If the American people would like to know the facts as they are, through a direct dialogue, then I am ready to conduct a debate with the President of the United States, President Bush, on television. I will say whatever I have to say about American policy. He will have the opportunity to say whatever he has to say about the policy of Iraq. And this will be in front of the world, on television, in a direct, uncensored, honest manner, in front of, as I said, everyone. And then they will judge what is true and what is false.
This is new. You are suggesting, you are saying that you are willing, you are urging a debate with President Bush on television?
Yes, that is my proposal. On films, we see that the Americans are courageous. When challenged to a duel, they will not back down, just as the Arabs would not. This will be an opportunity for him to convince the world if he is committed to war. If he is convinced of his own position, this will be an opportunity for him to convince the world that he is right in making such a decision. It could also be an opportunity for us to tell the world our own side of the story and why we want to live in peace and security. I believe that it is the right of the American people, the Iraqi people, and the world that we show our evidence clearly so that they can see for themselves. So, why should we hide from the people? Why shouldn't we show them both perspectives? We, as presidents, President of the United States and President of Iraq. This is what I am calling for. We will either make peace, and this is what we hope for, and spare our people harm, or whoever decides anything other than peace will have to convince his own people with the facts. This is the gist of my proposal, my idea.
This is not a joke.
No. No. I call for this because war itself is not a joke.
Mr. President, where would this debate take place that you imagine?
The American president in America and Saddam Hussein, the president of Iraq in Iraq. And then the debate can be conducted through satellite.
Oh, so a satellite television debate.
Yes. And if Mr. Bush has another proposal, then we are prepared to listen. What is important is the idea.
Would you be prepared to come to the United Nations for this debate?
The most important thing is that our debate be heard in a normal and accurate way. And by this, I do not mean that I go and I make a speech at the United Nations and then that Mr. Bush will make his speech at the United Nations. That is not what I mean. What I mean is that we sit as we are sitting, you and I, now. I will address questions to him and he will address questions to me. He will explain why he wants to go to war. I will explain why we are insistent on peace and we want to maintain peace. And we defend our honor and our sovereignty and our rights. So that the American people, the Iraqi people, and the other peoples of the world will hear us. Without tricks, without editing, without prepared speeches, people want to hear live and direct dialogue.
Well, this surprises me, but I want to make sure I understand.
أن تنقل في التلفزيون الأمريكي كاملة.
The debate could be broadcast on American and Iraqi television in its entirety, and it should be broadcast live.
والبث مباشر.
A live international debate via satellite.
نعم تمام.
Yes, of course.
How would this work? Who would moderate this debate?
نعم سيد رادر.
You, Mr. Rather.
With respect, Mr. President, I have plenty of other problems. I've got enough problems already, but I...
As soon as the White House heard of Saddam Hussein's proposal for a debate, it was immediately rejected. A spokesman called it not serious. During our interview, everything